ha 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 ha. He 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 ha 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 ha. Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature they call the gazette, who balances things on his head, because it's flat. Or a striped living pipester from Upper Mount Bat. Or sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat. And then the cat will say, after all those years being stuck on a page, did you ever imagine you'd see me on stage? Now there's no telling what, main shoe. No, there's no telling what, but I'll give you a clue.
I play Maisie, and the preparations that took place for this character was to basically just copy any sort of 2000s mean girl, because Maisie's incredibly egotistical, and that's not quite what I like to think I am. Yeah.
Hi, my name's Seth, and I play Horton, the elephant, in our little, well, whatever this is. So part of what I did to prepare for the role of Horton was I listened to the original soundtrack, and I listened to how the original Horton would sing, and I would try to capture that essence in my performance while at the same time putting my own little spin to it. So it's still a unique iteration, my own iteration of Horton the Elephant. Oh, and as for my costume, one of the things I did was I bought a custom shirt online and had them print out a picture of Horton on it. Right there, see? And then I wore this gray jacket on top with the hood up. So, yeah, that's me, Horton the Elephant. All right, next person.
Hi, I'm Julia, and I'm playing as Jojo. Jojo is a very imaginative character, and my preparation for this is that I try to like act imaginative and like a very happy kid, because like, you know, usually when you're imaginative, you would always act happy. So yeah.
Hi, I'm Abby, and I play Gertrude McFuzz. And in preparation for playing Gertrude, I watched different productions of Seussical, and I learned more about Gertrude. And Gertrude is an awkward, determined bird who has one feathered tail, and she's very upset about it. And that's pretty much it. And for the costume, I just got two dresses and feathers and other stuff. And yeah, that's it. Enjoy the show.
On the 15th of May, in the jungle of Nul, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing,
splash!
Enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the Elephant,
Horton the Elephant, Horton the Elephant,
heard a small noise.
So Horton stopped splashing. He looked towards the sand.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around.
Then he heard it again.
Just a very faint yelp.
As if some tiny person were calling for help. I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked, he could see nothing there
but a small speck of dust blowing past
through the air.
I say, how confusing. Why, I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that is able to yell. So you know what I think? Why, I think that there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear that he'll blow into the pool. He's no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
So gently, and using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his great trunk through the air. He lifted the dust speck and carried it over and placed it down
safe
on a very soft clover.
It's McElligot's pool. This might be a pool like I've read of in books, connected to one of those underground bricks, an underground river that starts here and flows right under this bathtub, and then who knows, it's possible. Anything's possible. This might go on long down where no one can see, right under State Highway 203, right under the wagons, right under the toes of Mrs. Ambroso, who's hanging out close. It's possible. Anything's possible. It's possible. Anything's possible. This might be a river now, mightn't it be, connecting McElligot's pool with the sea? Then maybe some fish might be swimming, swimming toward me. Oh, the sea is so full of a number of fish. If a fellow is patient, he might get his wish. And that's why I think that I'm not such a fool when I sit here and fish in McElligot's pool. It's possible, it's possible, it's possible. Anything's possible. It's possible, it's possible, it's possible. Anything's possible. It's possible. Anything's possible. My sword?
I've been guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain, at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. I found magic, but they don't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings, yes, I can fly around the moon. soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me. I have wings.
I have wings.
Yes, I can fly.
I can fly
around the moon and far beyond the sky. Well, someday soon you will hear my plea. One small voice in the Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, Jojo, the mayor's child.
Oh, well, I'm Horton, the elephant.
Are you real, or are you a very large thing?
Oh, I'm real, all right. I would state that in English.
In my thinks, I imagine a lot of strange things, and I go to strange places as if I had wings. I love a good thing.
Well, for me, that goes double.
Sometimes my things are what get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
In bright colors!
Me too! And I go to strange places, like Solace Saloon.
When you think, do you think you could fly to the stars?
Little friend, no one else could have things such as ours!
Yes, I have wings. Far beyond the sky, you call my name and you set me free. One small voice in the universe,
one true friend in the universe, who believes in me.
Good night, Jojo.
Good night, Horton. See you in Solace Saloon.
Love Song for Horton, number 437.
Gertrude, a sorry sight, but I'm gonna take you under my wing and baby, you'll be all wet.
I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-offish, what's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing show-offish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement.
The more crumbs I found, I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor, Dr. Dick by the lake, and he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now I'm amazing, Maisie, as better as better can be now. Amazing, Maisie, it was all for sale. Amazing, Maisie, the birds are all whistling at me now. Amazing, Maisie, baby, that's my sale.
Hi, hello, gee, it's fabulous. Watch her go. Gee, I'm envious.
To and fro, Maisie's fabulous tale.
I wish I had one like it.
Left and right,
best I've ever seen.
Day or night,
kid, you're turning green.
What a sight, Maisie's fabulous tale.
Get those pills and you can have fruit. Your heart on is certain to see, and you can be as amazing, well, almost as amazing as me.
To the doctor named Dake, whose office was high in a tree by the lake. She cried, Mr. Doctor, oh please, do you know of some kind of pill that will make my tail grow?
Zohar di ala pindi shofkay in the rilak. Clearly, that's been proven in all birds of nations. In other words, your tail is just right for a bird of your kind. Alright, alright. Bring in the pizza de bouche.
Together, we could be great.
something more.
Now I've become a someone who has someone to believe in and to be there. You're kind and your powerful heart. So notice me more now.
Oh, the world would be something.
Notice me more now.
If they notice the thing or two.
Notice me more too.
The way I notice you. $2,999,999. Ugh, it's hopeless.
Who, me? I'm confused now. They said I have to sing another solo, but there's only one song for Maisie, so I guess I have to go and sing as Gertrude. Abby, can you help me?
Yeah, sure.
So, what do I do with my hair and my clothes?
Oh, for your hair, you have to, like, take pills. Or, like, it can be buns if you want. And put some blue pom-poms, I guess. Just anything blue for the hair ties and stuff. And for the clothes, you're just going to wear a white blouse inside of a blue dress. And for the makeup, here, eyeshadow. You're gonna use blue eyeshadow and you can put yellow if you want. That's what I did.
Yeah.
And be awkward, but just be simple.
Okay.
I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little, it was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides, which the tail was too heavy for normal flying. Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I'd been foolish because I couldn't even help, you know, I couldn't even fly, and I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was going to go through all the labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dake, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dake, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out. Get it off. I won't do it again. Ouch, it hurt a lot. Ooh, a tender spot. Just a one feather tail.
But suddenly, Gertrude the sail.
I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk for you. I would trample through the trees full of furious bees for you. I stalked through a fog and a choking smog. I saw this soap through a stinking fog. My grip was slipped by a vicious dog. For you, I got it through snow and 11 below for you. Yes, even though I knew I was catching the flu for you. Achoo! And then you were following my soul and I rolled down a hill out of all control. I broke my fall on a jagged shelf for you. For you.
All for you.
All for you.
All for you.
There is nothing that I wouldn't, and I couldn't, and I haven't gone through. I spread my little toe, and I hobble like a doe for you. more thing. It took me 7 weeks, but I found your clover too.
Gertrude, I never noticed. You're amazing. Hello? Who's? Can you hear me? Hello? Can anyone hear me? Who's? Earth to who's? Wake up!
Traveled so far. Oh, Jojo, please forgive me, wherever you are.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm thinking of you and wishing we all were in Sala Salu. They say breezes are wonder and people are kind. Maybe it's something like heaven. I close my eyes.
I've had so much trouble finding my way there. When I get close, it is a
peace. If we can get there, we're gonna stay there. If it takes us miles,
if it takes us miles,
if it takes us here.
High on the mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find.
Salu, sala, salu, sala, salu, sala, salu, sala, salu, sala, salu, sala, salu.
Something like heaven, and because breezes are nice there, and there might not be pandemic there.
I would like to bring everyone I love to Sala Salu, my family, friends, pets, so that we could experience more peace, more happiness, and if we could actually get there, I hope we can enjoy more and less sadness, fear, Yeah, we could just relax and enjoy the beautiful place.